I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy. Come on, can we sing high and lifted up? High. Shining in the light. Oh. As we sing holy, holy. To see you high, high and lifted up. Shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy. Sing holy, 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 holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. I want to see you. I want to see you. Anybody want to see him? Say, I want to see you. 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 Oh, come on in the house of Zion. Can we give God a hand clap of praise? Is it good to be in the house of the Lord one more time? To see him high and lifted up, shining in the light of his glory. Come on, I don't know about you, but I need him to continue to pour out his love on me. I need him to pour out his love on me, because as he pours it out on me, I can pour it out on others. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless God for just allowing the opportunity for him to fill this temple. God is in the house. We have welcomed him in. We done said, open the eyes of my heart. So that means he done opened your heart up now. Now it's up to you to receive what he has for you. So we bless you. We welcome you. It is good to be in the house of the Lord this Sunday, September 22nd. We are so excited, y'all. This year, I'm telling you, it's just like, it's just blowing by. It's going to be Christmas next week. I'm just saying. That's how fast these days and weeks and months seem to be going by. But I am so just honored and blessed to have this opportunity to be here with you. Our good Reverend Darrell is out today delivering the word of the Lord. So can we just pray for him real quick together? Lord God, we just ask right now in the name of Jesus that as you use the vessel of this house, Reverend Darrell Smith, Lord God, that you would just touch him, that you would love him, that you would rest on him, Father God, and let the word of his mouth and the meditation of his heart be acceptable unto you, Lord God. Let him deliver the word with boldness and clarity of thought, Father God, that the lives he is ministering to might be forever changed. God, we bless you. We thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. It is good to be used of the Lord. And so we want to encourage, whether it's being used in this house or used out there in our community, we want to make sure that we are spreading the gospel and that we are covering one another in prayer. Amen. So we're going to go ahead and flow in our service. I am going to go ahead and by proxy, Minister Teresa, ask if you would get a scripture, amen, and you come do the scripture in prayer, and then after her, we will have Sister Rachel who will come with the announcements, amen.
morning. All right, so wait a minute now. Can you all pray for me and give me a minute, because we must be always ready.
Always.
Always ready. So we can do all things in Christ Jesus, right? All righty now. All right, so. All right, thank you, Lord. The axe fell. I'm going to read out of 2 Kings 6, verse 6. And the man of God said, "Where fell it?" And he showed him the place. And he cut down a stick and cast it thither, and the iron did swim, the floating axe head. Father God, how great thou art. Lord God, we know that you can do all things. We know, Lord, there's nothing impossible with our God. Lord, we bless you this morning. We thank you for all the souls that are here, Lord. We thank you for those that are listening on the internet. We thank you, God, for giving us grace to rise up out of our beds today. We thank you for the grace to walk and have our limbs in our right mind, God. We thank you for this place of worship. Oh, my God, we pray that you continue to fall fresh on us. Oh, Father, we pray that you continue to give us a burning fire for your word as we step aside from our daily routine, Lord. We're stepping into the house of God. Now prepare our hearts. Let this be holy ground right now in the name of Jesus. And we welcome you, Father. We thank you for the leaders of this church. We pray for our pastor this morning, Lord, that you continue to pour into him. We pray for the anointed word to come forth, Lord, but prepare our hearts that we can receive, Lord, and go out and pour out. Lord God, we thank you for this day. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Once again, I'm seeing your lovely faces. It just puts joy in my heart. And I'll be giving you the announcements for today, September the 22nd, 2024. So with sorrowful regret, we announced the funeral arrangements for Sister Elizabeth Gordon, which will be here at Siloam on Monday, September the 30th from 9 to 11 a.m. and the viewing service will be at 11 a.m. I hope that you'll be able to make time in your schedule for this, just to bless the family. We also have an in-person joint board meeting on Thursday, September the 26th, beginning at 7 p.m. sharp and not CP time.
All right now.
Save the date. October the 13th at 3 p.m., we will travel with our own Pastor Randy to celebrate the pastoral anniversary of Bishop Matt Eggleston at Holy Dove Fellowship Church in his hometown, Coatesville. And also, Operation Christmas Child. Woo!
Yeah.
I gotta tell you, at the flea market yesterday, and if you feel convicted that you weren't there, you should. But there was a great presence of Siloam here. Pastor Randy was there. Elder Nicole was there. Reverend Minister Alfini. I get these titles mixed up, so forgive me. But my sister Alfini was there. Pastor and Sister Wes were there. And everybody sold something. And I'm just going to show you this. I'm wearing a piece of Pastor Randy's mother this morning. And don't it look good? $5. Just saying, it was a bargain. You missed a bargain. Now, continuing on in the spirit of Operation Christmas Child, it's not too late to help. We are going to have a packing party, and this is my ask of all of you. On the third Sunday in October, I would like each one of you to commit at least an hour of your time to stay after church. Now I'm going to feed you pizza and salad, and then I'm going to teach you how to pack a box. Now here's the cool thing. You don't have to bring anything with you except for your beautiful heart. And then you're going to be doing mission ministry. You're going to pack a box and pray over a box for some child that God has identified around the world. And they're going to receive your box, and it may be the only thing they get all year. So put your heart into this box. Now, it's not hard to do this. I'm actually going to demonstrate to you how to do this. You're going to have everything you need to do this. All you have to do is show up. So if I could just see a hand of someone who feels moved by this message that tells me you're going to be here. Awesome. I really should see every hand up in here. Okay, so there's a few hands, but you got another week to give me some more hands, okay? All right. Now, because you guys are so beautiful, and because you're my extended family, like some of you guys are higher than my natural family, just letting you know, okay? I'm going to do something for you. I'm going to do another second annual church-wide Christmas party. And you know what, who we might have here? We might have, and you guys can pray with me on this, but we might have St. Titus's Bell Choir here.
Yes, yes, yes!
They were moved at the flea market by my testimony of how great the people of Siloam are under our same God, the Trinity, which, by the way, I told them. And they actually took 25 Operation Christmas Child boxes off my table. Because they were so moved by the testimony. So you can see how God is working in our community through his believers at the Siloam Baptist Church. Let's not let St. Titus show us up. Let's start taking our boxes home today and bringing them back next week. You can do this. 7 days, you can pack a box. It's not hard. You can fill this box with $20. You can pray over this box and ask God to give you bargains that only make it $15. God can do anything. Okay, but we want you to put your heart and soul in the box. So don't give us the remnants in your drawer that you said, oh, this is an opportunity for me to dump the contents of my drawer into this box, because that's not what we're doing here. We're not asking for your old used clothes and shoes. We want new stuff. And just so you know, at flea markets, they bring new stuff. I bought wild toys at the flea market with the tags still on them. Okay? So you can go to places and find cheap things. Ollie's has a lot of cheap things. Walmart has a lot of cheap things, so you can do this. You can go out to my Amazon wish list and get a lot of cheap things, okay? So if you need to know how to do that, come tap me after service. I'll tell you how to do it. Okay, and now just to end, I'm not trying not to belabor my time here, but I do have a Black Love moment. I've been on this series of HBCUs, so this will be probably my last one this month. I'll have something new next month, but I want to give you this because I think it's important. And before I read that, I also wanted to mention to you that there is a shredding event coming up on Saturday, September the 28th from 9 to 12. And as you know, these don't happen that often, so you want to mark that on your calendar. And in case you don't know what HBCU means, because you know we hear these terms all the time, we don't always know what they stand for. It's historically black colleges and universities, okay? And there's a history behind these. They have been at the center of American history for over 180 years. Did you know that? Many notable black Americans have attended HBCUs. For example, Vice President Kamala Harris went to Howard University. Amen. Oprah Winfrey, who's a billionaire, by the way, went to Tennessee State University.
Yes.
Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. went to Morehouse College. And the first black U.S. Supreme Court Justice, Thurgood Marshall, went to our very own Lincoln University and Howard University.
Yes.
NFL Hall of Famer and TV host Michael Strahan, who you know is successful, went to Texas Southern University. In the beginning, not the beginning of the Bible, but the beginning of HBCUs, after the Civil War in 1861 to 1865, HBCUs emerged to provide black Americans the most basic of human rights, access to full education. Prior to the Civil War, the education of black Americans was prohibited in most southern states. It was often discouraged in northern states as well, resulting in only a few black schools in existence. Cheney University was one of them. That was in 1837. The University of the District of Columbia, 1851.
Yeah.
Lincoln University, 1854.
Right.
And Wilberforce University, 1856. Now, most of our nation's HBCUs were started by philanthropists and free blacks, southern states at the behest of the federal government, and religious organizations such as American Missionary Association and the African Methodist Episcopal AME Church. By and large, the first HBCUs were established to educate children of formerly enslaved people and train them to teach other black Americans. You get that? Blacks helping blacks. That's a new concept, huh? It's an old concept. Because HBCUs were the only schools available for most black Americans, they often provided primary, secondary, and post-secondary education. So during the Renaissance, from the late 1800s to the 1900s, HBCUs thrived and provided refuge from laws and public policy that prohibited black Americans from attending college. HBCUs provided undergraduate training for 75% of all black Americans, holding a doctorate degree, 75% of all black officers in the armed forces, 80% of all black federal judges. Think about this. There's a correlation between HBCU and success. Think about it. Before higher education was desegregated in the 1950s and 60s, almost all black college students enrolled at HBCUs. Legal segregation had prevented black Americans from attending college in the South, and quotas, and there were quotas, limited the number of black students that could attend college in the North. Today, there are 100 plus HBCUs. You didn't know that, did you? Across the United States. And they continue to play a vital role in American prosperity academically, socially, and economically. HBCUs are also becoming a magnet for international students. A lot of us are not aware of this, but largely due to their strong academic programs, and their programs are strong, affordability, because they really are affordable, and diverse and inclusive environments. So it's not just black students that go to HBCUs. There's white students, there's Asian students, there's Arab students. There are students of almost every ethnic background at an HBCU. So you can consider an HBU a melting pot.
Amen.
Similar to Philadelphia.
Amen.
You've got all cultures, you've got all mixtures, you've got all skin tones, you've got all economic backgrounds, and you got some full rides thrown in the middle of all of that. So, tell your grandchildren, tell your nephews and your nieces and your sons and your daughters and your neighbors and everybody you can think of,
support HBCUs.
Right.
We want to see them go forward into
Amen.
The future.
Amen.
Thus concludes my announcements for this morning. Thank you very much.
Tell the Lord, thank you.
Sorry. One last announcement while the music ministry begins. I forgot to mention that there's a blessing downstairs for people in the form of hot piping coffee. So if you need to go to the restroom and you just need to pick me up real quick before coming back into the service, go get some coffee. Hopefully it's still insulated and warm at the end of service, but I encourage you to get some coffee. Also, once a month, Wawa is going to donate coffee and donuts to the Siloam Baptist Church.
Come on, put your hands together and tell the Lord thank you. Come on, tell the Lord thank you. The HBCUs are good, the coffee is good, the donuts are good. The clothes that we wear is good. But how many of you know that if the Lord doesn't make a way, if the Lord didn't wake you up this morning, if the Lord hadn't gave his life, if the Lord hadn't created the earth, the least we could do is give God some praise in his house this morning. If you love your daddy, if you love our daddy, come on and tell him thank you. Come on and put your hands together and give him a hand praise. Come on and give it to him this morning. He's worthy. He's worthy of the praise. I don't know about you, but I will bless the Lord at all times. His praises shall continuously be in my mouth. Here's a little simple song that y'all can all join in on if you don't mind. All right, it's not about me, it's about the Lord. And it says, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. For he is worthy, worthy. For he is good. Yes, he is good. Is that all right? Thank you. clap your hands. Clap your hands. Clap your hands. For he is worthy. Song. Thank you, Lord. I, help me, just want to do what? Thank you, Lord. Yes. A simple song.
Know what I'm talking about.
yes, he saved my soul.
Jesus. Hello, everybody. Welcome. James, you know Waymaker? Can you just play that softly for me? I'm excited to be in the house of the Lord today, and I want to welcome everybody who is here with us and all those who are also watching online. Hey, online, can y'all just wave at the people online? Hey, we want to tell y'all, come in the house. Come on, don't be shy. If you're sick, we pray your healing in Jesus' name. But as soon as you get better, we want you to come on in the house. And if you're not sick and you just decided to stay at home, we want to just give you a little nudge to come on in the house. It is good to be in the house of the Lord. This is Siloam Baptist Church. We are located at 1329 Willow Street in Norristown, Pennsylvania. Now, I was pulled aside at the beginning of service because we have a guest here today, and they don't speak English. So I'm going to use my little bit of Spanish to invite them and make them feel welcome in the service. Is that all right? Can we embrace this individual? I'm not going to point them out because I don't want to single them out, but I do want them to feel welcome. So bienvenido a la Iglesia Bautista de Siloam. Nos alegra que esté aquí hoy. Te bendecimos en el nombre de Jesús. Okay, so I'm gonna sing a song because he was trying to worship with us, but he doesn't really know English. So I'm gonna sing a song that we all know, but I'm gonna sing it in Spanish. Okay, all right, here we go. I'm gonna sing it in English first so y'all can follow me.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Milagroso, abres camino. no cumples promesas, luz en tinieblas, mi Dios, así eres tú. Milagroso, abres camino, cumples promesas, luz en tinieblas, mi Dios, así eres tú.
Come on, isn't he a waymaker in every language?
Milagroso, abres camino, cumples promesas, luz en tinieblas, mi Dios, así eres tú.
Come on, you can sing it in your own language. It's all right. Sing Waymaker.
Milagroso, abres camino, cumples promesas, luz en tinieblas, mi Dios, así eres tú.
Come on, you sing in English. I'm going to sing in Spanish.
Milagroso, abres camino, cumples promesas, luz en tinieblas, mi Dios, así eres tú.
Come on, he's a way maker in every language.
Milagroso, abres camino, cumples promesas, luz en tinieblas, mi Dios, así eres tú.
Encourage my friend.
Milagroso, abres camino, cumples promesas, luz en tiemblas, my Dios, así eres tú.
Come on, let's lift it all up in English. Waymaker, here we go.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Hallelujah. In every language, he is the miracle worker, milagroso.
Hallelujah.
He is. Gloria a Dios.
Gloria a Dios.
Sí.
Gloria a Dios. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
The promise keeper. Cumples promesas. Para siempre cumples promesas. That means always he's keeping his promises. Luz en tinieblas. He is the light in the darkness. It don't matter what language you sing it in. My God, mi Dios. When I'm hurting, when I'm broken, cuando estoy cansada, that means when I'm tired, he's my God, mi Dios, así eres tú, that is who you are. So we bless God, and I thank God for sending this individual to this house, that we might have the opportunity to minister to that person. I'm telling you, Siloam, y'all better get ready. This is the intent of the gospel. That we would spread the love, the amor of Jesus to all people. So I pray that everyone feels welcome and that you feel welcome. Bienvenido. We are going to transition and we are going to keep in the flow of worship and our giving. So I'm going to ask Minister Al Howard if he would come forward to do the offering appeal.
Good morning. Good morning, Siloam Baptist Church members, friends, all to you who are online. We thank you for joining us this day. We thank you for the moving of the Holy Spirit in this church this morning. I'm here before you to make an offering appeal. You know, Jesus said his blessings. It's better to give than receive, right? So our Bible speaks to us around this topic. There's a scripture in Malachi 3:10. That's the last book of the Old Testament. And it states that, bring all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. And try me now in this, says the Lord of hosts. If I will not open for you the windows of heaven and pour out for you such blessing, that there will not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sake, so that he will not destroy the fruit of your ground, nor shall the vine fail to bear fruit for you in the field, say the Lord of hosts. And all nations will call you blessed, for you will be a delightful land, says the Lord of hosts. Let us look to the Lord in prayer. Lord, help us to bring our offering with a eager heart, not as a comparison with others, but as an act of worship to you. And may we find the comfort we desire in you and the strength we need in your name. And may your presence be with us every hour of the day. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Thank you.
Good morning, church family. Can the congregation please rise and follow the instruction of your ushers? Hi, Richard.
Thank you.
Amen.
We will now have our ministry of music.
And fair. Oh, I sing.
I sing.
Thank you because.
Because.
I'm happy. Oh, I sing.
I sing.
Thank you because.
Because.
I am free. And one of these mornings, you go in to look for me. I'll be that city so bright and fair. I know that
heaven is a beautiful place because the Bible tells me so. Where two rivers run through the middle and the streets are paved with gold. Where all of God's children are going to live up there in a city so bright and fair.
I know that
heaven is a beautiful place because the Bible tells me so. Where two rivers run through the middle and the streets are paved with gold. Where all of God's children are going to live up there in the city so bright and fair.
I know that heaven is a beautiful place because the Bible tells me so. Where two rivers run through the middle and the streets are paved in gold. Where all of God's children are going to live up there in a city so bright and
standing up my timber. Standing up my timber. Standing up my timber.
Testimony to be able to send up some timber every day, not every once in a while, but every day. Hallelujah. 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 thank you. Thank you for your goodness toward us. Lord, that's why we just sing hallelujah to you. For God, you've been better to us than we've been to ourselves. Thank you that we couldn't wake ourselves up this morning. But thank you for watching over us all the night long. We may not be feeling the best in our bodies, but God, we thank you for things that as well as they are, even right now. Thank you, God, for food on our table. Thank you for a pair of shoes that we can put on our feet. God, nobody told us to breathe, but thank you for breath in our bodies. Thank you, Lord Jesus, just for helping us in our times of difficulty. Lord, you're just so good to us. We'd rather just say thank you than to complain right now, God. Even though there are things going on and around us everywhere, but God, we just lift our voice collectively and corporately just to say thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you.
Father, we love you.
Yes, Lord.
We appreciate you, God. We honor you this morning. In the name of Jesus. God, I pray that you'll let the words of my mouth, let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, to be acceptable unto you. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. What a glorious day this is. The sun is shining. A little Christmas in the air. But we're walking on top of it. Hallelujah. I'm excited this morning to just be in the house of the Lord one more time. This morning, as the praise and worship was going on, and we were singing a few songs, as the welcome was given, I got a little bit disheartened. The invite came and said, "Why don't you come on in the house?" I got a little bit discouraged because we who are in the house, we act like we're not glad at all. It's hard to invite somebody in your house and you ain't home. Glory to God. Folks won't notice you in the house unless you make some noise.
That part.
How many of us want to go to heaven? Look at all them hands. Can I tell y'all that there's noise up in heaven? Can I tell y'all there's noise up in heaven? Folks are rejoicing in heaven because God is good. Anybody in Siloam know that God is good? I said, anybody know that God is good? Why don't you show some signs that God is good to you? Come on, give him some praise this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen, amen. God. God bless you. God bless you. Good to see you. Good to be in the house one more time. On this coming Thursday morning, don't do that yet. I already got my running shoes on. This coming Thursday at 11 o'clock, Brother Charles Fisher, sister, will be funeralized on this Thursday at Ebenezer, and we want to continue to pray for him and for those of us that can go and support Brother Fisher on Thursday. Let us go to Ebenezer. Amen. And just support our brother. Yesterday, somebody help me say yesterday. Yesterday, the men had an awesome, and I mean awesome, fellowship on yesterday morning. I was so blessed by the fellowship and so blessed by what God is doing with our men. Every man just stand up. Every man stand up. You can't stand, just wave your hand or do something. Amen. It was exciting. It was exciting just to see what God is getting ready to do with all of our men. And men, I'm just so proud of y'all. I'm proud of us. How God is orchestrating things in Siloam for our man-to-man ministry. And thank you, guys. And let's not stop. Let's continue climbing this mountain. Amen? Amen. Amen. Where's Brother Savio?
He went downstairs.
Yesterday, Brother Savio had a football game. And he won his game. Amen. He's downstairs. Amen. And we men are going to really start supporting our young men. Hello, somebody. If it's important to them, it ought to be important to us as well. And amen. And every time we get an opportunity to go to somebody's game, we're going to do that and make our presence known with them as well. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you all so much for praying for my mom. Shirley is doing pretty good. I called her this morning, and she told me I had a rough night last night. I said, but you're still breathing, huh? She said, don't get smart, boy. Don't get smart. But she's doing fine. Mom's doing fine. Her blood pressure still won't work right. But we know who controls our blood pressure. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Amen. Thank you all for your prayers. I will tell you this before I preach. My mom was so low, and girlfriend was on her way out the door for the third time. And the doctors said to my mother and said to me, I want to know this God that you serve. He said to her, what it is, but you are a miracle child. Amen. And my mom told me, it's just God. It's just the God that I serve. And he said, I want to know your God. I want to know who your God is. So she told him. Amen. 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 But every day she's getting a little better and better and better. And I'm making preparations for a girlfriend to come home. Amen. Yesterday, I want to give kudos to my big brother, my good friend. I love you so much, bro. Pastor West, good to see you. Amen. Amen. Pastor West and Sister West were sitting out there with us yesterday, and it was just a magnificent time of being together, even though we weren't really communicating, but I had my eyes on him. Amen. I got two passages of scripture that I want to share with you this morning. The first passage of scripture is in St. John chapter 3. Mm-hmm. St. John chapter 3 is probably one of the most familiar verses in the Bible that we ever know. Yeah.
You don't have to stand right now unless you want to. But the word of God declares to us in John chapter 3, verse 16 and 17, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him, who that believeth not on him, is condemned. But he that believeth not is condemned already, because he had not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds are evil. I read this scripture this morning in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. The English Revised Standard Version in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I'm a noising gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver up my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. The Bible says love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude.
That's right.
It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful.
Wow.
It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part. We prophesy in part. But when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. This morning, I want to preach from this subject. He loved me through my good and my bad. He loved me through my good and my bad.
Thank you, Lord.
I want to say that one more again. That he loved me.
He loved me
through my good
and my bad.
And he even loved me through my bad. As I was driving home from the hospital with my mom, I just kept reflecting on the goodness of our God. And then I turned on the radio just to hear some soothing music, some songs, and to take my mind away from the hustle and bustle of the day and what was taking place with Cheryl Girl. I know that I talk so much about my mom, which is probably a good indication to some of y'all that I'm a mama's boy. And I don't mind being a mama's boy. But more importantly, I know of a surety that I am my father's child.
Yes.
I know that I am my father's child. I kind of deviate and want to deviate a little bit from what I got on my paper, because he loved me through my good. Can I tell y'all this morning without y'all judging me that he even loved me through my bad? When I was a little child, some folks in the neighborhood said, "You was a bad boy." And I never thought I was bad. I always thought I was good. But God still loved me. Through all of my good, which was a little bit, and all of my, which was a whole lot. The Word of God tells me that he loved me so much that he gave his only son for me. Do I have any company here this morning? And as I was sitting at my desk at home, I just couldn't imagine. I just could not imagine how much he loved me. Even with all of my mistakes, the inconsistencies, the betrayal, and the downright unfaithfulness I had become to him. Church, I just can't imagine why he loved me so. I said in my new members class this morning that even while we were yet sinners, Christ died for me. Even when I was doing my dirt, I only did a little bit. But even while I was doing my dirt, he loved me. And even while I was not even honoring the God of my salvation, he still loved me. Even when I tried to walk away from him, he still loved me. I may not imagine, you may not exactly imagine, but aren't you glad that God loves you? I want to cross-reference this title and remind us of this father or this certain man that had two sons. One son was older, and then there was this younger son. It kind of reminds me of how spoiled, how disrespectful, and how evil, how mischievous some of our kids are today. When we look out and we even see the rudeness and the badness of some of the children, it kind of galls us up, but it helps me to remind me that it wasn't just them. It was some of us too. But then I have to remind myself that God loved me. In my good times, and even in my not so good times. Then I had to tell myself back then was no different as how things are even right now. This father's young son decided it was time for him to let his hair down and stretch out and see the world. Perhaps he thought to himself that the grass was greener on the other side. No doubt the thought of all of the good stuff that was happening on the other side of the track. He himself decided, that's where I want to be. That's the stuff I want for myself. That's what I want to do. My mama had to remind me some time ago when I was coming up. She said, don't get your britches up too high, son. I remember when I came home from the military. Mom was sitting in her living room, and I came over and tried to give her a hug, and she grabbed me with my nice press uniform on, grabbed me in the collar. She said to me to remind me that I'm still your mama. And I said to her, I said, Mom, I'll be back in a little while. Mama said, you see what time it is? I said, yes, ma'am. She said, I don't care where you're going, but you better be back in here at 10 o'clock. I wanted to tell her, honey, I'm grown. I ain't got no curfew no more. And she said, 10 o'clock. Then she reminded me that the door was locked. Now, I'm a grown man. But she said, but you still my boy. Our children have a tendency not to respect time or parents. I ain't talking about y'all kids now. Cause I don't want no guns being pulled out on me today. But the disrespectfulness is still going on. And as the record reports, he goes to his father, suggesting, Daddy, you owe me. As I was sitting down writing this, I said, he said, what? That you owe me my inheritance. And then he said, I don't want to wait till you die, but I want what I want right now. Can I tell you that this young man had big ideas, but he didn't have any respect. He had big dreams of seeing what's new and how he could become the 2024 hip-hop swinger. He had visions of living on his own because he felt like he was grown. But if he had just asked some of us who found out the hard way, we would have told him that everything that glitters ain't gold. Pastor West, I'm gonna cut across the field. So he goes to his dad and he gets his inheritance. Then he goes to where the Bible describes he went to the far country. Can I just suggest to you that anytime you go away from God, you are in a far country? That far country will have you to venture out and leading you away from God. The reality of all this is that there's mere fact is that sin and curiosity caused this young man to spend what he had. His sin caused him to waste instead of invest. His sin allowed him to squander that which was given to him. He should have known that to whom much is given, much is required. But he decided just to let the good times roll. This is a powerful lesson and a warning to any one of us that may have a desire to wander into sin and travel to the far country. Well, church, he finds himself working in the field. What does this happen to do with him? You see, at one point in time in his life, he was living a good life. He had everything that he needed as long as he was in his father's house. But can I tell you just one more time that when you step out from your daddy's house, you are headed for big trouble. But as I look down the road, and as I realize that even while he was in his daddy's house, he was doing good. But when he stepped away from his daddy, he began a downward swing. And so, my brothers and sisters, as long as you're with God, everything will be all right. You may have some bumps and bruises, but God is able to soothe every pain. If you only keep your trust in him. This boy went out into the country. He found himself working in a strange place, working for strange people. But all but God. God had enough of him being where he was. He had enough of being where he was, but God still had mercy on him. Can I tell you one thing, church? And I'm gonna hurry to my close. God sees you and he knows you. Not only does he see you, but he knows what you're doing. And you ought to be in the time of your life where you've had enough of sin. You had enough of carousing. You've had enough of going the wrong way. And come on home to God. Because the Bible says, God so much loved you that he gave his only son. That whoever, will you raise your hand and just say, I'm in that whoever club. Whosoever believes in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. This is what the young boy said. All my money's gone. Nobody here to bail me out. I want to go home. Siloam, his condition brought him to his senses, and he realized what his fate would be if he continued to do wrong. So he made a decision to go back home. And this is what he told his dad. You loved me through my good. You loved me through my bad. His daddy told the household, get the fatty calf, because my son is coming home. While he's coming up the highway, he told his dad, Daddy, you loved me when it was good. me when it was bad. And this is what got me. You didn't erase my future because of my past. You didn't erase my future because of my past. You never took your love away from me. Thank God you didn't write me off because of my past. Can I tell you this morning, and I'm not picking on you, Governor, but can I tell you that some of us had a bad past? That God can't reach you. That's why Jesus, that's why Brother John wrote this like he did. For God so loved you. That he gave his only son. The good part of this is every last one of us is going to die one day. That's right. We all going to perish. That's right. But aren't you glad he loves you?
Yeah, Lord.
Come on, don't fool me now. Aren't you glad? With your past, it was so bad. Well, let me not talk about you. Let me talk about me. It was so bad. If you look down through the annals of time, I got to save that. I got to save him from himself. Anybody on my show? But because he loved me. Can I drop one more nickel? I'm going to put this nickel in the meter because I'm going to stay here just for 2 minutes. He loved me in spite of me. He loved me in spite of all of the things that I had done. Oh, he loved me in spite of all that I was doing. Uh-oh. He loved me in spite of what I do even now.
Right on. That's right.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
His love runs so deep. He loved me just that much. God hears you. And like the boy said, God, you love me. That's when we find out that God so loved the world. Here's the best part. I want you to get this one. That God's love stretches to the widest span. Can I give you one more? God's love gave us the greatest gift. God's love suffered the greatest sacrifice. So God's love calls us from the greatest confidence. He calls us for the greatest confidence. God's love results and resulted in the greatest. his rescue.
My Lord.
I just want to see one hand. God rescue. Will you answer this question? Won't he do it? You couldn't save yourself.
Hallelujah.
He rescued us in time. Rather than allowing us to spend in eternity in hell. Just in case there's anybody on this side of the house, and you think you're just that perfect, let me remind you, he even died for you. On this side of the house, because I know that boy back there in the green shirt. Come here, Governor. Come here, boy. Come on, come on. You come here. I'm not coming to you today. Said he loved me through my good and my bad. And before we get too happy, I got 30 more seconds. Is there anybody here today that's outside of the ark of safety? So everybody in here good? Everybody in here good? If he were to come in 30 more seconds, everybody good? Monica, you good? Kim, you good? You good, Governor? Deacon Scott, you good? Kachaka, you good? Bro Fisher, you good? John, you good? Alfini, you good? Nicole, you good? I didn't know your name was Nicole. Now I know. All the good folk, if you're good, come on, stand to your feet. What's the name of that song? All right, thank you. Well. I sing because I'm happy. I sing because His eye is on the sparrow. Glory, hallelujah. You're the reason. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. I sing the praises to you. I know we're all standing, and I know sometimes we do this because we don't want to be the only one that's sitting down. I'm not going to let Pastor Randy point me out. But if you're not saved, he threw out his lifeline, and he's throwing out his lifeline. Remember, I don't care how good you are, and I don't care how bad you are, God loved you through your good and your bad. I'm going to drop this other nickel on you real quick. Some of us are going to leave from here and follow up with the bad. But one day, we're going to get tired. But God still loves you. God didn't call the perfect, but He's calling those of us who struggle with everything we got. And if you're in that category, I don't mind. Come on. Come on to Jesus. He'll fix you up. And the thing that I do know, that when He fixes you up, you'll never have to worry about it again. Monica, come up here real quick. Hurry up, baby. I got 30 seconds. Come on, you ain't traveling fast enough. Turn around. One of these Sundays, I want you to hear her testimony. You're talking about God fixing and rescuing, rescue in action. And all she does is tell God, thank you. I'm happy for Monica because she said God rescued me just in time. We bless you. We praise you for who you are. Father, it is in Jesus' name that we love you. We thank you. We thank you and we love you for what you continue to do with us and for us. Father, we ask that you'll continue to bless us. Continue to keep us, God. Thank you for loving us even through our good and our bad. Continue to smile on us, God. And God, not if you do it, but while you're doing it, we're going to praise your name because you're worthy to be praised. Father, we thank you. Now, God, we ask that you dismiss us from this place, never from your presence, because we need you, God. We need you more now than we've ever needed you before. We ask that you'll bless your people. And as we leave from here, God, take us to our destination safely, with no hurt, harm, or danger. And then, God, bring us back on the appointed time. And we'll run back in the door and give our testimony of the goodness of our Lord. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior, who is Jesus the Christ, the love of God, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, rest and abide with us henceforth, now and forevermore. Let all God's children sing together, amen. Amen. Tell somebody you love them as you're going out the door.